In this video, I'm going to show you the best 4K export settings for YouTube. So to get started, on my timeline, I have a video that I've done editing and I want to export it. Now the first thing we need to do is to go to the first frame of our video. And then I'm going to select an endpoint by clicking I on the keyboard. And I'm also going to select an out point by going to the last frame of the video and select O on my keyboard. And the reason I'm doing this is to tell Premiere Pro that this is a section that I want to export. The next thing we need to do is to go up to File, Export, Media. And just click on that. And then you will get this export settings window. The first setting we are going to look at is the format setting. So you can change this to whatever you like. But for YouTube, it's recommended that you are using H.264 for a regular 4K video. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Preset, we're not going to worry about. And we're not going to worry about comments. The output name, this is where and how you want to save it. So if you click on this, we can change where we want to save it. So I'm going to find my folder I want to save it. And I'm just going to write some names right there and click on save. You also need to make sure that you have export video and export audio selected so it will be exported. And here you can see a summary of all of the settings. And I'm going to get back to that down in the menu right here. But here you can see that this is a 4K video, 3840 by 2160. And it's at 29.97 frames per second. Down here, we also got some menus. So we got effects, video, audio, multiplexer, captions, and publish. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to look at the video setting and just make sure that you can see here that your video is in 4K, so 3840 by 2160. And I'm just going to leave it. Same goes for frame rate and field order. All of these settings I'm just going to leave as is. But I want to check this box right here. Render at maximum depth. So I'm going to check that. Further down in the menu, you can also have some encoder settings. And this is for the hardware or software encoding. Now, since I don't have a dedicated graphics card on my Mac, I'm going to choose software encoding. But if you, for example, have a computer, a Windows computer with a powerful graphics card, I highly recommend that you use hardware encoding. We're going to leave all the settings right here, but just make sure it's called main and on the level 5.1. I'm not going to worry about this. Then we scroll down here to the bitrate settings. Now I think this is one of the most important settings that you can do. So right now it's selected to VBR one pass. And we can click the menu right here to see CBR, VBR one pass and VBR two pass. CBR means a constant bitrate. So you can see right here, right now, target bitrate is 10. And if we change this to 100, you can see down here that our estimated file size jumped up quite considerably. So this is now a bigger file, but you also get really good quality. So if you're exporting for YouTube, I highly suggest that you use CBR and keep it as high as possible. And if you want a little smaller file size, you can change this to 60 to save some space, but I'm going to leave mine at 100 for the best quality. The next thing is to check this box right here, use maximum render quality. So I'm going to check this box right here. And then we can simply just export and Premiere Pro will export your footage. To learn even more about Premiere Pro, click on the video on the screen right now. And if you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.